This may look like your average American warehouse, but Agility Robotics claims it's actually the world's first factory for humanoid robots. Let's go check it out. Agility Robotics was founded in 2015 as a spin-off company from Oregon State University. Its manufacturing facility is called RoboFab, and it's here that Digit, its best-known robot, is being produced for clients such as Amazon, who are at the testing phase. Peggy Johnson is Agility's CEO. Peggy, thank you for having CNBC here. There's a lot going on in the background that we'll get to. But tell us more about the RoboFab. When did you build this?
Yeah, it's been in production for about a year, and we've outfitted it to build our next generation robot. The capacity of this 70,000 square foot facility is 10,000 units a year. We will roll up to that over the next couple of years.
What are companies asking of you? Why the need for this level of production?
Well, the biggest tailwind out there is the large labor gap. There's over a million jobs in the logistics area alone that are going unfilled. Robots like Digit can step in and take those tasks off their hands.
I do wonder about that. People might be looking at Digit and saying, wait a minute, that's my job.
Well, what we're seeing is this is typically a part of the job that they don't like. We can offload that, free up that human to have more cycles in their day to learn new skills.
The current version of Digit weighs 160 pounds, that's 72 kilograms, and stands at 5'9", or 175 centimeters. The robot can lift 30 pounds, or 13 kilograms, a weight limit set by the U.S. Occupational Safety and Health Administration. And when it comes to Digit's battery life,
in the existing generation, we had about a 2-to-1 ratio. So it would charge for an hour, you would get 2 hours of use. We're moving to 4-to-1 with our next generation.
Version 4 launches in October 2024, but Agility is already working on version 5.
In the next generation, we will incorporate what's known as collaborative safety, where you can have humanoids working alongside humans. We'll have incorporated AI more fully, and of course, we'll have the ability to have Digit recharge itself through our stand.
Hi, Digit. Like many other humanoid robots out there, Digit is integrated with AI and language models.
We want to be able to partner with all of the AI companies out there. We are involved in NVIDIA's Project Groot, where they are building a robot foundational model.
To show us how it all comes together, I spoke with Melanie Wise, Agility's chief product officer, who insisted, Digit, show me what it's capable of. Here we go. All right, 25 pounds.
25
Thank
pounds.
You, Digit. Yeah, that is heavy. How many times do you think in an average day?
Every 19 seconds for 8 hours straight.
But Digit's like not even breaking a sweat. What if there's some sort of incident and they drop a box or they tip over?
When Digit has a mistake that is irrecoverable, it'll go down to the ground and then it'll make it possible for a person to come in and help Digit.
Should we check out some of the software? Walk me through what we're actually seeing.
Yeah.
This is sort of the brain behind Digit here.
Yeah. So what we're showing on the screen is two separate panels. The one on the left is where we can actually see what Digit is thinking. Here you can see behind us, it identified three totes, and now it's picked a tote to pick up. So we're tracking the tote in the robot's hands and things like that.
Talk about this current hand situation.
So there's actually two styles of hands. Here we have the paddle grippers and then the claw grippers. Long term, we're moving towards making the hands interchangeable because sometimes customers have very specific requirements.
The legs are really unique looking.
One of the nice things about the legs of the robot is they go backwards, and that allows us to get very close to shelves. Digit's head is predominantly used to house all the cameras so that we can see around us better.
Talk a little bit about the data collection and how that helps them continue to learn.
All of our robots are connected to a cloud platform that we call ARC. And that cloud platform is where we upload telemetry data. We use that data for training the robot to do certain things.
Alongside Digit and its accessories, ARC is one of Agility's biggest sellers. Customers get to choose from the company's CapEx model or, customer favorite, robots as a service model.
There's a monthly fee for that. and it includes all of the software and the maintenance and support.
What about the cost? If somebody were to come in and say, I want to buy one digit, is it comparable to...
Think of it as a luxury car.
Since it was founded, Agility has raised about $190 million in capital, which it's used to build RoboFab and, of course, Digit. It's still yet to turn a profit, but as operations scale up, there could be cost savings to be had, especially as the plan is to have Digit build future versions of itself. The mass production of commercial humanoid robots is becoming a reality thanks to companies and spaces like these. To be sure, a lot of work still needs to be done, but as this industry evolves, we could start to see robots move off of factory floors and into our everyday lives.